In Sri Lanka, over 90% of women have experienced some sort of sexual violence in their life growing up. An average rape case takes around 14 years to be heard, with one successful rape conviction in 2018. Let those numbers sink in for a moment. This obviously makes rape victims more reluctant to come forward, which directly contribute to the underreporting of rape in our country, with the perpetrator then continuing to get away unpunished and unchecked for their crime, and the victim choosing to live their life in silence. This is the sad reality of the situation that we live in.
Sexual objectification and victim blaming are common behaviors that make up a phenomenon known as rape culture. Sadly, in Sri Lanka, a vast majority of girls undergo traumatic sexual experiences from a very young age. Statistics indicate that 1 in 4 girls is sexually abused before she reaches 18. And in the past 8 years, at least 4 women were raped every day in Sri Lanka. Rape culture normalizes rape due to societal attitudes towards gender and sexuality. So where does it stem from?
Rape culture comes, one, from the fact that sex education and discussion of sex, the practice of healthy sex, is so suppressed that some desires come out more as perversion. The other is, say, rape is actually more about power than it is about sexual release. And I think that stems more from the patriarchal system that we have in place. There is a large gap in the distribution of power, and there are a lot, most of our people feel powerless, and that suppression comes out as sexual aggression.
Sexual offenses included in Sri Lanka's penal code span rape, statutory rape, incest, sexual abuse, and sexual harassment. And there are a few basic things that all girls and women must be aware of in order to take the right steps against any sexual offense they may experience. It begins with lodging an entry at the police station.
A rape or any offense that comes under the criminal laws or the penal code has to be first reported to the police. But there are instances where people either call a lawyer or a civil society organization when something has happened. So the duty of that lawyer or the civil society organization or any person is to first direct that person, whoever the victim is, if it is in this case a rape, to direct that person to the police station. So it can be the area police station where you live in, or the Women and Children's Head Office, which is in Colombo, in Armour Street. So ideally, if it is a rape situation, you are entitled to first go and report to the police, and the police will take down a complaint, and thereafter they will send the victim to the judicial medical officer for a test. And once the investigation, the first investigation is done, they will arrest the accused, and thereafter the process will move to courts.
However, victim blaming plays a significant role in the reluctance to report these crimes. What was she wearing? Was she all by herself? Was she drinking? Sound familiar? And once a police complaint is made, it is essential to pursue the case relentlessly to avoid it from being brushed over like many others. This process is exhaustingly time-consuming and forces the survivor to revisit the trauma repeatedly, restricting healing. The stigma surrounding being a rape victim, as well as the inadequacies of our justice system, call for reforms and change on multiple fronts. And we as a nation need to step up and take responsibility in order to facilitate change. So what can we do?
Rape culture can only be changed when we collectively admit and acknowledge that it does exist in our society and that it needs to be changed. Now, while we can't use social media to fully eradicate rape culture, we can, however, use it to open up doors to have people speak more vocally about the trauma that they've been through, to help create more conversations around this subject, like the Me Too movement that empowered women everywhere to speak up about this type of assault and trauma that they have been through, to create more awareness, reform, and justice to the situation.